I get it. I know the Adventurer's Guild is a huge advantage for us. The discounted potions, the intel we get, but damn these union dues. I mean, 120 gold pieces a month. Yeah, maybe it's because I grew up poor, but I do not like seeing money leaving.
Honestly, friend, you picked the wrong barkeep to complain about the guild to. What do you even think it is that they do with your gold?
Well, I assume it's to maintain their facilities across the world, and to fill our stores.
The guild makes enough off of contracts alone for all that. Let me ask you a different question. Why'd you become an adventurer?
Well, when I was a kid, my village was stalked by a night hag, and some adventurers from the guild came and saved us. Apparently, my mother had been its next target. So I wanted to become an adventurer like them, to help people like me and my mom.
It's a lovely tale. And I'm really glad that it has a happy ending. But how do you think those adventurers were paid?
By the alderman, I suppose.
Do you think your village could have afforded adventurers that could afford to take on a night hag?
Now that you mention it, no.
You see, way back in the day, before the guild was as prolific, there weren't really protections for clients out there. Often, villages or farms would bankrupt themselves to be free of some monster, and then be unable to rebuild or recover and would fall to ruin anyway. Adventurers risk some of the most brutal deaths imaginable. They risk their lives, so it makes sense that they should be paid really well for their work. But not everyone can afford to pay. Hell, the people who need us most can't afford to pay. So, the dues that are collected by the Adventurers
Guild... pays out adventurers for their contracts.
Exactly. Of course, there'll be payment from the client, but it's usually something they can handle or done in payment plans for however long they need.
Wow, I really had no idea. Thanks for educating me, barkeep.
Don't worry about it. It's sort of my thing around here.